You know, I love my shoes, and I really don't want to hear a very bad word about any of them. But I can reluctantly concede some styles are better for your feet. They're a bit more comfortable than others. So to take us through an assortment of wonderful shoes and the health of our feet, podiatrist Brendan Brown. Good morning, Brendan.
Good morning.
I don't know if I really want to speak to you, really.
And look, I don't know if I want to speak to you, Carrie-Anne. You're killing me. Every time my patients and etc. see me, they know I come on your show, and then you are wearing these shoes and these heels and promoting it, they're telling me, why is this such a bad thing? Carrie-Anne wears them.
Exactly.
Yes.
So, but let's talk about the health of our feet. And you know I love my shoes. So,
you do?
What is the very worst shoe that a person could wear?
The very worst shoe is probably the highest stiletto you can think about. That's mm-hmm. That's the very worst shoe we could wear.
Can I perhaps pick up this particular? Is that a very high stiletto?
That is a reasonably high stiletto. Although there's an email going around at the moment that showed some very, very high shoes, even higher than that, and they just grip me with fear. That is a podiatrist's dream. There's many an injury there to come into my office with that shoe. So
okay, what about adding the platform?
The platform definitely helps it, because what it's really doing, it's, as you know, creating an optical illusion, but in fact also creating a little bit of stability in that shoe, so that's really helping that shoe.
Okay, but if one had a very high heel without the platform like that, and that's actually not even as high as shoes can get, why is that a bit dangerous for foot?
Oh, look, that has no support whatsoever. That is, to me, again, a very scary shoe. It looks like candy and probably is just about as good as wearing a piece of licorice on your foot. It really isn't a very good shoe.
It is a beautiful shoe.
Yeah. It's so good that you could eat it. But, look, the problem with that shoe is, once again, the really narrow heel. It's not too tall, which is a great thing, but the fact that the shoe is just so narrow in the heel, and it's really pushing that centre of gravity forward, which is just creating enormous pain, not only in your feet, but way up the chain. We call it your chain, so your knees, your hips, your lower back,
your
shoulders.
Let's talk about why the high heel and the stiletto. What happens physically to us, and what's connected to the knee bone? And go on the way
to
up
the hip bone. Should we get up and have a look?
What do you want to do?
Really, what I'd like to do is let's get you up. Let's get you to stand up here, and we'll watch you in shoes on first.
Okay.
So let's get up here.
I'm wearing my very practical ones because you were on too.
Yeah.
Girls from Cosmo would be horrified.
Okay.
But anyway, okay.
And so what we really need to do is if we look at Carrie-Anne now, and Carrie-Anne, can you take your shoes off for us just for a sec?
Mm-hmm.
And see, what that's doing straight away is it's not allowing your pelvis to fall forward.
Okay.
It's also allowing... Now, can you grab up and go onto your toes? And one of the things that happens automatically is we all start shaking. And the reason that part of that happens is that our core stability is now much
So now you're telling me I've got to go to the gym.
Yeah, that's right. or just wear a lot of heels. So it creates a problem with our core stability. It pushes our centre of gravity way forward.
So with high heels, our centre of gravity goes this way.
Yep, so we're talking about 3 to 5 centimetres in front of you. Your gravity, centre of gravity. So that's going to put lots of pressure on your lower back, lots of pressure on the musculature in your hip. It's going to internally rotate your knees, and even create problems up in your upper back. So that's a real, that's like a trifecta of problems for you. That also comes to the problem, as you know, you will well and truly know, that now that you've worn so many shoes, for you to go into a flat shoe...
Hurts.
It hurts big time. Because your muscles over years... I've seen a lot of flight attendants over the time, and the girls on those airlines are having to wear, as part of their uniform, high heels. So what they have to do is they totter onto the plane, and then they get home and go into those flat shoes, and instantly they have pain. So they've got pain up into their calf muscle, because the calf muscle, from spending so much time in a shoe like that, is in fact shortening.
Okay. Well, given the fact we're not going to... stop wearing high heels.
No. And we wouldn't ask that. No.
So, if you are inclined to wear high heels, a lot of people, as you say, flight attendants, people working in shops, restaurants, they want to wear a good heel, a reasonable heel.
Yep.
How can you then work on your muscles and your back and your knees and your hips to alleviate the health issues?
Look, first of all, you should get yourself a bit of a stretching program. So you're right, almost go to the gym. Make sure you've got really good core stability, because that helps in wearing anything like that, because that's going to help all of your postural muscles in your, even your lower back and your core. We need to make modifying the shoes that we wear, some stretching in the calf muscles, the hamstrings, and also a little bit of lower back stretching. And that's going to prepare us for wearing those shoes. If we're going to wear those shoes, we probably want to walk around making sure that we spend a bit of time in those shoes before we spend a big night in them.
Okay, yeah. What about a heel like this? Because this is a really funky shoe, Sonny Reichel. A really funky heel like that.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's got a lot of stability in it.
And it's much better than this, for example, because this is really narrow, and you're definitely likely to twist your ankle or move in this shoe, despite the platform. So this in, for example, wow, this is a special shoe.
Isn't it?
It's beautiful. Look at that, there's a bit of flair. Really narrow heel. But really pointy toes.
Okay, what does
really
the pointy
high
toe do to us?
Well, once again, it's narrowing that base, okay?
And
so
what
this
happens
is much
then?
Broader, much narrower.
So when you crunch your little toes.
Unstable, yeah. When you're crunching them up, you're less stable in that shoe. Okay, and what it's also doing is, of course,
so when you say less stable, what sort of health injury can that cause?
Oh, once again, we're going on to those stability problems. So you're more likely to sprain your ankle. You're more likely to get lower back
pain.
Will
it do anything to the bones in your foot if you stuff them
in
your
shoe? No doubt. This is like a corset for feet. It really is creating lots of trouble. So it's squashing all those bones, so it's likely to push those bones out of place and create lots of problems.
Look at these girls. Come on, work with me here, ladies. Is this fabulous or what? I mean, how can you say that's bad for
I'm
you?
I'm probably not supposed to.
Is this a health hazard, please?
It's a health hazard. I can't say that doesn't look nice. It's a lovely shoe.
Oh, even boots like this. This can't be all bad for winter. I mean, winter, these look good.
Yeah, they look very good. Once again, that's a better boot, as boots go, compared to this. Yeah, it's got lots of... That shoe's got more width in this area. It's broader in the heel. It's naturally going to be more stable for you.
Okay, well, let's get to some hit points about the health of our feet. And what we should, in fact, over there, just those boots there, flat boots, good or bad?
Lovely. Beautiful. You can't go wrong with this boot.
It's practical. Yeah. okay.
You say that like it's a bad thing.
Okay, the hit points of what we should do for health of our feet our back.
We should be doing things like stretching regularly to make sure that we're making sure all of our muscles are stretched. We should prepare. We shouldn't be just running out in this shoe. If you're going to go out, prepare, get used to wearing this shoe so your body's used to wearing this shoe. Make the shoe broader in the forefoot, broader in the heel section. The lower the heel goes, the better it will be. You're overall going to be more comfortable. Think practically, only wear this shoe from the cab into the venue. Don't wear it tottering down the road.
We could take our little ballet shoes. We could wear the ballet shoes in. What about ballet shoes? There's not a lot of support in that.
No, but it's definitely going to be...
Beautiful shoes, though.
Yeah, they're a lovely shoe, and it's definitely going to be more practical for long-distance walking than this shoe is. So, you know, you've got to consider...
Well, you're running marathons in these things. You know, how long is a cocktail party?
a couple of hours on your feet. It'd be great for you to wear a pedometer one day and tell us how much you're actually walking at a cocktail party.
Well, I've been doing it for a while, Bryn.
Yeah,
I have been, but listen, I do know the value of what. So, we if you are going for something a bit more practical, I mean, I get away with the others, but I probably don't do the marathons in
that's
them.
That's right.
I sit a lot.
And you've got used to wearing them. People aren't as you know.
And I just want to thank the girls at Cosmopolitan, because they always help us out with our fabulous shoes that are really just too divine. Thank you very much. But Brendan, great advice, and I do listen to you, I promise.
Thank you. My patience will be much heavier.
Brendan George.